Hey everybody, it's the Poltergeist 5000 back with more Majora's Mask. In the last episode we went through stuff we'd already been through, just to get back to where we were in the dungeon before. In this episode we're gonna keep going through. I'm gonna try to record the rest of this dungeon now, because I don't want to have to later. This guy's helmet looks like Andross from Star Fox. How do I kill this guy? I forget, honestly. Do I use the hookshot? Maybe it's the hookshot. Ugh, just let me use the damn D-pad on these menus. I'm ready to drive me crazy. Okay, that is totally what you do, but now I just gotta kill this guy. There you go. Okay, don't. I didn't want to go that way. What's down here? There's a hookshot target on the ground. Way to spoil, like, the eventual twist here. What use could a hookshot target on the ground be? What situations can you imagine where a hookshot target that seems to be on the ground would be useful? I don't know. Maybe you got a hookshot through like a web on the ground or something, and your hookshot goes through, but you don't. I don't know. The point is, you know, they make it. You know, I'm sure the idea was supposed to be like, oh man, this huge twist that the entire temple is going to turn upside down at some point. But they telegraph it like crazy throughout the entire first half. Like, what's the bloody point, you know? Well, this guy looks mighty. Looks like a big statue. Oh my gosh, it's an Igor! I think these guys have actually appeared in other Zelda games, but I couldn't tell you which ones. I'm out of magic. Oh shit, I'm out of magic. Can you hit this guy with regular arrows? I'm gonna give that a definite... doesn't look like it. Oh. Yes, you can. But you have to wait for him to open his eye by attacking you. Okay. Well, thank goodness I didn't have to leave the dang room to get more magic so I could shoot more light arrows. That first night cannot come soon enough, let me tell you what, man. As soon as that first night falls... I wish those stray fairies gave you magic. That'd be really convenient. Like, even instead of health, because I don't mind so much the lack of health, like, that doesn't bother me. It's just, like, not having frickin' magic is a real problem when you need magic. Because it's... Fuck off! Just fuck off! Okay, let me go here. There's probably some magic in these pots over here. Fairy? What the hell am I gonna do with a fairy? Dude! Get away from me! Fuck off! Anyway. Okay, so, is there magic I can get anywhere in this room? Because there's suns in here that I can't activate without a light arrow. There you go. Hooray! It's almost like you don't even need magic refilling items because everything... You know, it's like when a big magic refill gives you half your magic bar back and, like, a light arrow uses, like, a tenth of it. Like, who cares? Who cares about, like, magic restoring stuff? Doesn't even matter. Dude. Friggin' hell. I'm not using a light arrow on you, so just go ahead and get hit by my hookshot before I get sick of dealing with your stupid ass. There you go. Okay, well, the hookshot didn't do anything, but... I never went... which way did I never go? I went left, right? I went left, right? Yeah, this is the only way you can go at the beginning. Yeah, I've been through here. What the hell, man? Because to the... all these motherfuckers respawn. Isn't that just hilarious? Isn't that just a funny gag? Yum, 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 yum. Leave me alone. I'm not interested in what you're selling, so just fuck right off. There you go. Get rid of this big-ass block. My neck hurts. Ugh. I shouldn't be recording this right now. I should be working on Void Enterprises stuff, because I got a whole bunch of... Because I didn't put anything up last week. Man, that guy's scary. Bombs you right in the camera. Oh, it's the compass. Okay, well, cool. Ow. Yeah, I should be working on Void Enterprises stuff, because I didn't put anything up last week, because I was busy. And now all of a sudden, you know, it's Thursday the next week, and I've done literally nothing more than I have last week. Except I still have all the stuff I got last week still to answer, which isn't a lot, but it's something. I don't think there's anything else I can... Wait a second, what's that? Okay. Well, it's a good thing I saw that when I did, or I was gonna leave the dungeon. Because the thing is, you have to leave and go back into the dungeon every single time you want to, like, do the thing. Oh, an upside-down treasure chest, yet more telegraphing, spoiling of what the twist of this dungeon is gonna be, you know? Like, yeah, it's mysterious and mystique and all, but don't you think it would have been more interesting if you had no idea and then you hit the red emblem outside the temple and it flipped the whole temple upside down and you were like, what the fuck? I had no idea it was gonna do that! But you obviously do. You know exactly what it's gonna do because the game, like, practically straight up tells you before it even happens. And it's still mind-trippy when it does happen, but the really annoying thing is that you have to turn it back right side up at some point. And when you do that, it puts you back by the owl statue and you have to do all the crap. You can't even, like, the emblem is actually blocked by these blocks. Like, I wish I was fucking kidding. No, it's the other one. It's always the last one you try, you know? Now it's gonna move back into place. Okay. And then I go up here, and then I press the button. Yeah, you actually have to stand on this switch, pull out your ocarina, pull it out in front of your face, go do-do-do-do-do-do-do, play the Elegy of Emptiness, wait for the Elegy of Emptiness to play so it puts a statue in front. In the 3DS version, they fixed this, I think. They put the, you know how the entrance to the dungeon kind of looks like a face? I think they put the emblem in between the eyes instead of behind this fucking block like a dumbass. I don't know what the hell they were thinking putting that there. But hit that emblem and the entire world goes upside down. Oh no! Ugh. Man. Ow. Ugh. Anything else? See, now we're back over here. What the heck? There's a... What? There's a bean sprout patch. What the hell could that possibly do? Oh, I got a... Don't I have magic beans? No. No, I did, but I reset the cycle. Here, let's do this. There's gotta be something interesting in here, right? There's bugs, and there's a bean... There's like a bean patch, a soil patch, that you can put bugs into, so let's see what happens. Please actually do something. Like, give me some rupees or something. Arrows. Okay, well, there you go. Mystery solved. Let's head back into the dungeon, shall we? So, like, the entire world, like, that's the sky below me. How fucked up is that, right? What is that? There's, like, fire on that. It's like a finger. Yeah, that was scary. Okay. It's interesting that there's actually Triforce imagery in the Stone Tower, considering you don't see that anywhere else in Termina. Stone Tower Temple, except now it's upside down, man. How mind-trippy is that? Like, jeez. This first room of the dungeon is barely recognizable upside down, because the ceiling is so abstract and weird. But right side up, it's all normal. Like, jeez, man. Which way do I go? I don't think I can go... What is over there? I can't see. There's a guy moving up and down. Okay. I see boxes, and I see a switch. Okay. I wish you could equip... You know what's really annoying is that you can't equip your arrows. You can't equip light arrows and regular arrows. You have to equip one or the other because you can't equip, like, the magic variant of the arrows at the same time as the regular arrows. Which is really stupid, but... Oh, man, I should have hit that when it was right side up. What the fuck am I doing? You know what the worst part is? There's no better time to go get that than right now. Well, actually, no, there totally is a better time to get that. It's one we've already beaten the dungeon, because that's probably just a stray fairy there. So yeah, I can get that when I'm done the dungeon. It's gonna put me back in Akana Canyon, but I can always just warm back up here. Do 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 do. What the fuck is in here? It's a sun cube. Dude, equip your light arrows, you stoop. Boy, if this were Breath of the Wild, I'd be able to pick that arrow right the fuck back up. No harm, no foul. But no. Ah. Don't judge Majora's Mask by the standards of a game that came out, like, what, 15 years later, at least? Okay. Oh, what the hell is this? This is the room that had the water in it before, I think. Suddenly it's just wind. It's like, what even is this? There's a door. No, that's a chest. Oh, man, I want that. Okay, what's in that? What's in there? I don't remember what's in there. Well, it's probably just a stray fairy. Let's not mince words here. I mean, how interesting could it possibly be? Thank you for making that. Yeah, it's just a stray fairy. It's just a flower. It's just a flower. Oh, I see something interesting here, down here, but I'm gonna have to go into my inventory, open up my inventory, hit R, go over here with the control stick, the ugly control stick navigating a grid-based menu, whip up my fire arrows. Oh, it's already hit. Never mind! That's the one I hit when I was right side up. There you go. Okay, so what's the gimmick to... Well, you need to get up. You need to go up, up, up. There's no way bad app. You know, when I was a kid, I used to listen to that album Shania Twain's Up. I used to ask my parents to put that on the CD player in the, dude, what the hell? Okay. I used to ask my parents to put that on the CD player in the living room so I could sleep. I'm not even kidding. do 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 do. Sooner or later, you practically become more familiar with the fast version of the song as opposed to the way it actually sounds. You start singing it like do da 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 instead of da 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 ba da da ba. Anyway, get out of here, Andross. That didn't kill you in one hit. Jeez, you're buff and you're tough and you can chuck with the best of them. Now you're dead. I don't even care that I used magic to do that, although I want those rupees. Boot, shoot. Give me rupees, thank you. Okay, I gotta get my freaking Deku mask back out because there's really no better... I guess I could have replaced my hookshot with the ocarina, but then I wouldn't have been able to kill that hip loop, man. Get blown up, thank you. Man, that just, like, suctioned me right into the middle of that. Oh, man! I'm in the air. I'm gliding around. And I see a switch that I have to shoot with an arrow. And my first gut instinct is pull your bow out in midair and aim at it in slow motion. But you can't do that. I have to land. Man. That should do it. Right about there. Yeah. I'm so happy. Son of a bitch, another upside down. You really gotta look around these rooms before you flip the temple. Because now that I think about it, I don't know if you actually do. I don't think you actually do need to flip the temple again. Just to complete it. But there might be a little bit of after dungeon stray fairy cleanup. You know, janitorial fuck. That I'm not excited for. I wish I didn't have to deal with that tripe. Deal with that crap! Oh, shit. Oh, goodness. Okay. Okay, well, this is... That's all fine and good. What the hell? I actually need to go outside. Oh, my fucking... I actually need to leave the dungeon. And go flip it again. You know why? Because I need to push the switch to get that, to make that thing appear, which is a key, which I need to get into that door, but you can only push that switch when it's right side up and you're a Zora walking around on the ground. And the annoying thing is, I was even, like, wandering around there in the Stone Tower preview video. Wait, no, you played the wrong song. Song of Soaring, not this Elegy of Emptiness. Please don't tell me I'm just gonna suck at this dungeon, because I can't take that right now. Of course, you know, the worst part, you know what the worst part is? I'm gonna have to... I told you this, like, before, that when you flip it back right side up, you have to move all three blocks into position again just to get back into this stupid fucking dungeon. At least I'm pretty sure you do. Last I checked, you did. Which is really, really annoying, but, well, what can you do? Hello, Mr. Moon. Hello, Mr. Moon. Alright, just fuck me up. Yep, here we the fuck are. What a load of shit. I push this one, and then it goes all the way over there, and then I pull up my ocarina. I don't have a mind to cut this all out. This is ridiculous that you need to do this shit over and over again. You know, I don't even normally mind when I'm playing by myself, but when you're in an LP, like, this is, you know, this is an extra 5 minutes that it didn't need taken, you know? You know, the fact that it's unambiguously my own fault for not being observant enough is the worst part. It's like, oh, and it's actually my fault, you know? No, blah, blah. I should do vocal exercises before I LP, because, like, I can't fucking talk, you know, so many of these episodes. I'm like, blah, 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 blah. Yeah, it sounds like my sisters are back from the dentist. They were both getting fillings, which is why I find it quite odd that they're being so freaking loud. Man, I'm an asshole today. Holy crap. Let's get back in the dungeon, get those two chests I missed like an idiot. Oh, my eyes. Oh, my eyes. You know, not to mention... I'm recording a new game come Monday. Where the hell did that even come from? Just, oh, by the way, I'm recording a new game Monday. It's like, what do you mean? What are you talking about? Well, it's a secret. So I probably shouldn't have brought it up. That bomb chew is getting on my damn... Die! No, you son of a fuck. I said die. Dude, how long is your fuse? Yeah, you know what? I don't even fucking care, because now that guy's out of my fucking way. And not being noisy. Except you're here! Hello, asshole! Okay. Okay, no, this needs to end. We're gonna end this dragonfly's life right here, right the fuck now. Die! Man. I can't record the rest of this dungeon today. Holy crap. I'm in such a shite mood. I go up here, and then I press the button. I hear that shithead just flying in, coming after me, you know. Just coming in like a breeze coming in between your unzipped pants, you know. Shut up. Oh, it's a good thing I kept the Zora mask equipped. Sink all the way down. Make sure to take as long as possible, because it's not like we're already past 20 minutes. Yeah, you know, you just walk right into those. I don't care. Oh, there's the chest. Oh, this must be the gem. Get out of here. Ugh. No, stop bumping into walls. Wait a second, that's right side up. What? What? Well, how do I get that chest to appear then? Oh no, was I stupid? Was I dumb? Have I been a bad? Dude, get out of my way, pillar. I'm not interested in what you're selling. No, ow. What the hell just happened? Okay. So how the fuck do I get that chest to appear? I need a key, man! And I don't have one. Where's that chest that I made appear? There was another one. There was another chest I made appear. Where is it? It's up there. It's up somewhere, but it's not up there. Is it? No, that was the chest I made appear. No! Oh, I am so stupid! The chest I just opened wasn't the chest I just made appear by pressing the button. It was the chest I made appear while the whole temple was flipped upside down. Holy crap. Holy cow, unobservant much? Jeez. Alright. So, ugh. I don't want to do this on screen again. Next time on Majora's Mask, I'll meet you inside the temple and it'll be flipped. Like, I'll start the recording in the screen transition. Okay, bye!